8:20 or something like that. And I'm off to one of the islands that's outside this. I'm going to Murano and maybe Burano. And Murano is the island of glass. So maybe I will buy something glass. This, doesn't this look canone sliante? Looks absolutely delicious. And also, these are rolling with chocolate during the day. So here I have some chocolate things you can buy. I was thinking about having a coffee because I haven't had coffee in 2 days, but I think I'll leave for so I can catch the water taxi. Now I get some happy thoughts again. It's very nice. At the train station, I actually bumped into, on the same boat ride, the Australian couple that I met outside Doge Palace yesterday, and then I did see them inside the castle, and now we were on the same boat. They've only had 1 day in Venice, and now they're off to London, and they're from Australia. So they were a really nice couple. I was sort of surprised when I turned my head and was like, oh my god, there you are again. We've seen each other 3 times during 2 days in Venice. This is the train station, Ferrovia. I don't know if it's called that, but Ferrovia is the boat station. And I'm trying to get hold to 4.1, 4.2, or number 3 or 12. And that will take me to Murano. The island of glass. So we actually have Murano here in 5 minutes, number 3. Or on the other side we have 4.1, 5 minutes. So let's see. Direzione Ferrovia. Took a little while. You have the boat that I'm going to, not that one, but the other yellow one. I'm going to the airport with that one, La Laguna. And here we have Venice all in its glory. And there was one who said, okay, go, the gentleman over there. Somebody said, oh, there's a factory over there, go there, but I don't want to go the first one. I need some coffee. Here we have a cafe and stuff. What do I sit down? When do I sit down? And let's walk the city and see what there is. Taxihållplatserna ser lite annorlunda ut här kan man säga. Jag är på en ö bredvid Venedig som heter Murano, som även kallas för glasön. Wonder why? Let's explore. I'm here at the sort of square, I think. I'm thinking about buying this clock with glass mosaic in a way. It has to be one or two things. Either original, beautiful. The second one is also you can use it in some way as, for example, a clock or a spoon or a, I don't know, or something. Well, if I don't have any choice, then I just pick one for like a souvenir thing. But it's nice if it can do two things, like a watch, like a clock. And then, therefore, I wanted to go to the factory that make them. So I can buy the clock from a factory that actually makes them. And I asked this lady that I bought this one, and he said, go to the factory and ask, because she doesn't know. Oh well. This is, we can say, the Grand Canale of Murano. It is pretty. And here we have some. And yeah, that's just keep on trying to talk here because I want to film the beauty behind. Look at this. They are so clever with how to maneuver a boat. I don't know if you actually saw it, but... the museum. I actually maybe should go to the glass museum while I'm here. There's a crossing over there, but it should be a crossing over here somewhere, but it's not, so I had to go back. Hello. Beautiful. And I will cross the bridge. And there's another bridge to the other side over there. So there was this glass museum here, but the entrance was 14 euro. That's about 160 Swedish crowns. Feels a little bit expensive. First thing I want to do is to find a factory where I can buy the things I want to buy. Another old tower, I think. And they have something, I don't know what it is. It's a sculpture. Two people. Oh, he's angry with him. Is he chucking him with a stone in his head? Or maybe it's water. And here is someone who's shy. He doesn't dare to look. But here we have one who really peeks. See, oh, what's going on there? There's someone who's just having a good time. So I walked all the way from over there, all that street, and then I went over this one. And I walked all the way here. And then I've been walking all the way here, over that bridge, and to here. And soon I will be turning here away. It's 12 o'clock. Maybe I should get something to eat. I really like that watch clock that was sort of velvety. No, it was like a bow. And it costed 18 euros. That's about 200 Swedish crowns. They have all this kind of... But I also like... I think they are very, very expensive, but when there's a lamp inside the glass, because then it sort of gives it that really, really nice shining thing. And all these small orchestras, I like them as well, but I can't buy an old orchestra because they're like 10 euros each. I'm following a group or something like that. But this is the Vetri Artistici Industria Ferro Lazzarini factory, Fornas glass factory. So I don't know if this is for free or if it's, I don't actually know.
Okay, please, we will do a very quick demonstration. Ciao, Mori.
Thank you.
trovare il video su quello che ho fatto il video a portare il video. Thank you, grazie.
You can take the boat here from here as well. This is the factory. And now I think it's okay for me to buy some glass. And what shall I buy? The clock that is sort of velvety, velvety, sort of like a bow. And there's the standing clock. And I have set my eyes on a Christmas tree as well with balls hanging in the tree. I have to figure this out. I think I've decided that I will take the square one because the one with the bow, it's bigger and it's probably easier to break. And how do I carry it? So that's what's made my decision. I'm going to that place where I also can buy the Christmas trees. I don't know if I've shown you any glass work. These are big ones. And I've actually seen also one kind of artistic way. It is also a souvenir of Venice. And there was one, but it costed 56 euros. But that is a lot for a clock. I should buy something that sort of comprehends all this train, all this the travel of 2019. I mean, I bought something in Malacca when I was in Malaysia, and that cost like 1,000 or something like that, Swedish crowns. That's 100 euros. So I could pay a little bit more if it represents the whole journey, but not this early on. So many hard decisions to do. Anyway, this is so gorgeous. This is really, really nice. And there's some very old mosaic windows over there. And this color is very, very nice. My health is much better today, thank you. I don't have a headache because I've been massaging my shoulders. And yeah, that's about it, I think. Bar Gelateria al Ponte. That's where I had a little glass of wine and a sandwich. Well, a toast. Didn't taste anything actually. Over there we have taxi buses. Maybe it's better for me to go there instead, because there was a number 3 and I think it's faster than the 4-1 and 4-2. Now let's find the shop where I'm gonna buy my glass. And it was by the bridge over here somewhere. And this is the little shop that I bought my things. There's a Christmas tree and a clock. That's about it, folks. And now I think I'm maybe taking the last place where you can take the ferry. That was a direct line, and where to now? Should I just go by boat a little bit? Oh, I'm earning up to my 40 quid because it's 7.50 one way, and now I've been going to the hotel, from the hotel to Murano, back from Murano. That's 4, so that's 30, And now I'm gonna do one more to the, so 37.50, almost 40, but then again, I had a card, so I didn't have to pay a ticket every time. And that sort of lingers up to the 250 that lacks. Or maybe I do another boat trip during the day. I think I am going in the right direction. For me, it's number 1 and 2. And I'm back home. And I think I will go to the supermarket. It's over here. So it was a good thing I stopped and asked if it's busy, and we probably have to wait for some boats in the mornings. And she said there is, so I just need to be here early tomorrow. Maybe, I don't know, 8:40, maybe 7:50, maybe. So I just bought water and Coke and the nice toothpaste. And I want to buy either from the chocolate or for the pastry shop and go to the room for a while and just wait until all these people go home so I can have Venice to myself. And I have to buy myself a keyring because I'm leaving tomorrow. That's the plan, and I think it's a good one. But the problem now, should I buy that gondola with solar system? Solar system? Is that right? Solar system. Or should I not? Here do we have since. Oh, I bought myself the keyring, and it was from a very small shop by the Rialto Bridge. It says Venice, and it has the Rialto Bridge. Oh, that's the way they cling, cling, cling when they come. It must be a nightmare to have deliveries in this town. My goodness, God and gracious. So, keyring, check. Now, I think I have to have the gondola, even if... I think... Okay, this is the thing. The thing is, this is the thing. I don't think I will go on a gondola unless I'm with somebody I really like, you know, like a lover's couple, or maybe a very good friend, though. Actually, me and Yuki could go on a gondola just for the sake of it, and, you know, just to have done it. And I don't want to go alone, but I do have a thing for the solar system. How's it sitting there, the gondola guy? And this is what I bought, and it costed 450 euros, 150 each, and behold, creamer. That was very far away. Well, good day, and welcome to my tasting corner. I smell chocolate and something else. The chocolate is rich. I dare say that it looked more delicious than it was. It was good, but the pastry is like a little harder than croissant. So it's like in layers and stuff. But on a hot day like this, when you cool yourself down with some Coke, nothing beats that. Oh my God, so good. Now I have two things that are similar to each other, but they're just two different flavors. One is chocolate, the one is, I think it's vanilla. This pastry is even harder. I don't think it's supposed to be. And the cream is very natural. Maybe it is. I think it's vanilla. It feels a little old. Like it's been laying in the shop for very many hours, as it probably has. And I can imagine the last one is the same, but with chocolate.
So, thank you for that. I won't eat it now. I will eat it, though. But I won't eat it now.
Good gracious.
And I was supposed to get a little bit more thin during this holiday. Well, there are a few weeks left, so let's get starving, shall we?
And I'm off again. It's 6 o'clock. I've been sort of in my room for maybe an hour or something, 2 hours. I'm going. Left. Oh, there's still a lot of people here. This church is actually in my guidebook. Yeah. So now you know that. I'm going to Cannaregio. That's the biggest part of Venice. It's in the north. And it's the part that not so many tourists go to. And just before, I got a message from my friend Nicholas, and he said, go to the Jewish quarters, because it's much less tourists there, and it's beautiful. So I'm starting with going kind of the same way I went the first night. Yeah, this is how, here you see, this is Alla Ferrovia, that's the train station. So people are walking this place, and I probably will walk it the next time I come here. So here we see a lot of glass things that you can buy inside Verona. So I really like the clowns, but I didn't buy it. I will see if I can find the clock I bought. Here they are, but I don't see how much it is. Oh, this one's so nice as well. So you can see that the sides are not palace-like, it's more like workers. Isn't this just beautiful? That's the main street. And this is the street of, oh God, my memory. Manila, something like that. This is going to take me to the Jewish quarters. This is just one quarter from the main street. This is where people live. They used to live like 100,000 or 200,000, but now it lives like 20,000. It's a tourist town more. And it's much more rough on the side. Yeah. Definitely another character here. And this is Ponte di Ghetto Novo. So I'm going to the ghetto, Calle Ghetto Novissimo. Wow. Looks like a prison, but I think people are living here. Campo di Ghetto Novo. So here you see actually life of a Venetian. Thing that I've learned about this ghetto is that this is actually the first ghetto in the world, because they said that the Jews could stay here in this perimeter, like a triangle, and it's called ghetto. That's from the Viennese. It's a place where you make things from iron and steel, when you melt steel and then form gjuteri, it's called in Swedish, and that is called the ghetto in Italian. So this thing, it's spread out throughout Italy and throughout the world, and every place was called ghetto because this was the place where they had had it. I'm terrible at this. In a place like gjuteri, you can make something like this if it's made of something metal. Because there were so many that had to be imprisoned here, they had to build higher and higher. And this is the Venetian skyscrapers. it's only 38 or something like that that are living in the ghetto. During this street it was very, very nice to just sit and relax and drink, and I was looking for somewhere that I might take a sip of wine, but I didn't find somewhere. Look at this. My goodness. It looks like there is something on the other side of this corridor. Nice. Enda stället I världen man vid en korsning kan få se en sån här skylt. It was karaoke or show. These are three Moors. Moors. There's the one in the corner who's got a new nose. That's the three ones that has given this part its name. Campo del Moro. And we go and look at the church, the Madonna della Ora, or something like that. Tintoretto was a painter who lived here in the 16th century, like in 1589 or something he died. But he lived here and he painted a lot of the things in the church over here that I saw, and also in the Dodge Museum. So he was quite famous. This dock is like from the 16th century, but of course it's been restored. But even so, här har vi lite konst på väggarna. Men visst ser det ut som att det är en man där bakom. Oh my god, homokonst i Venedig. Let's go this way. That's a strange new building in the church, or what? Maybe it's not a church. I don't know, I think we're going to come into a piazza or something over here. It does not really fit into the environment. But hey, I'm not an architect. Campo dell'Abbazia. Campo dell'Abbazia. Everything looks like a warehouse, and not that one. Where to now? I think I'm going that way. This looks like a warehouse or something like that. So then it's not that strange, but it could be nicer. I did Google Casanova, but this didn't come up. Because I thought it was something about Casanova and Venice. But nothing came up, and I was like, okay. But then he was imprisoned in the Dodge Museum and escaped there. And now I see there's a Casanova Museum. I've been sort of robbed. Well, not really. But this is for the next time I come to Venice. Let's go to the Casanova Museum and maybe have a Casanova hunt. So here you really see that you have like a dock here directly into your house. Oh, that's an old one. So you go directly into the house. So I'm sort of heading back. I think it's 8:30 or something. So I need to pack and get ready to go to the airport tomorrow morning. Fondamenta della misericordia. They're pretty good if you want something to eat by the canal, but not in the center. Oh yeah, I came and walked from that way to the other way. This is where the guy drew Mona Lisa and some other girl. So this... Chiesa di Santa Fosca. I really splashed it up when the ambulance came. That was my seat for a couple of minutes. Oh, I'm so full of that beer. But that was actually a very nice, well, you could call it sort of an ending, because when I came to Venice, I started by sitting by Grand Canale waiting to check in. And now I took some time to just sit by the Grand Canale before I go home and pack my things. And here's to the... Ooh. Now, not that far away from my hotel. So here we have Burger King. Here is where I bought my gondola. Here is the church. And I think sort of my room is up there. That's my window, the one to the right. Isn't that nice? And I didn't get any candy. Oops. Baby guys, baby bye-bye. That's the door. Just go here. Oh, it's wet, so I don't want to fall in.